Well, check it out, folks. It's a Ernie Ball fill in the blank Music Man Axis. Kind of an interesting looking guitar. I'm just starting to look at how screwed up it is. Walk with me. Talk with me. See what I see. Okay, first of all, without doing anything, the frets are like really flat. Like there's no crowns on those whatsoever. I don't think it was like that. Or maybe it was. Next on the list of things we hate.
Yeah, just another quick eyeball. The neck really looks bent. Way more than it should be. Yeah, that's not good at all, so we'll have to see if Mr. Truss Rod actually works. But the other thing that's really, like, atrocious is the string action. It's like, I'll just do a quick measure. This is a Fender scale guitar, so. Yeah, the string action's like 7? No, actually almost 8 64s. 7. Yeah, just 8 64s. Although this is a locking trem guy, I've learned that this one's not designed to float back and forth. It's meant to sit flat, and that's the way they made the guitar, and that's what it does. Oh, let's look at some more stuff.
The other thing that's going on at this end is the first fret action, or nut action, seems to be acceptable on the treble side, but the bass side is out of whack. And then I'm looking closely, and I know the light's probably not getting that, but there are some shims under there, or a shim, so that'll have to get corrected. I think the neck angle is just out, because this is there's no way to dunk these posts into the dirt any more than they are, and that's way too high. But let's just see if we can actually straighten out the neck. What else did I see? Oh yes, on the back we have that. And just for fun, I haven't done it in a long time, I might do a little different finish repair. Lacquer stick melted into that big ugliness and then polished smooth. I might. We'll just see if the neck straightens out, right, guys? Like, what do you think?
So it's got the spocus nutus, and I'm just going to. Are those ratted, or is that the wrong size? I was just going to loosen off this locking thing for the time being. It's really tight too, the springs are seriously jammed in there. Yeah, wow, guys, you don't need to do this. That's nuts, right? Like, that's how things get wrecked. That is the turned in there. All of them are like that. Like lug nuts on a freaking tractor trailer. Are you kidding me? Come on, don't do that. This one's scaring me. Like it really is. Come on. Oh, yeah, they just need to be snug. Holy caroli. That's how stuff gets wrecked. That's why we can't have nice things. What was I yakking on about? Oh, does the truss rod work? And I want to be able to loosen the strings a bit before I go cranking on it. Let's just see if we make the neck straight, because I'm going to have to take the neck off and crown those frets if it's ever going to work. So that would be a good thing. What did I have here? This guy, this ball, like there's not even any tension on it, guys. Right? See, this is bad. This is a bad thing. Copy that. So like even if the truss rod isn't really needed and the neck is the desired straightness, it should have a little tension on it. It shouldn't just be floating loose like that. And then we get into the, you know, it's meant to be adjusted incrementally over time. Not like in one big heap after you realize the neck on your guitar that was in a closet for the last, you know, year and a half has suddenly got a bowed neck. Well, we're touching there, are we? I don't know. Give it another little turn and see what happens. But hey, you get what I'm talking about? Right? Sometimes the truss rod just won't save it. Wow, that's really nice now. I like that. That's straight. So we're just going to stop there. So that works. So I guess we're just going to take the strings off it and take the neck off it. And yeah, they're all just like flat. I'm just hoping I can just crown them and everything will be wonderful. I surmise that is the case.
A few markings. It appears it's from 2002. And there was a bit of a shim in there of some type, but really isn't accomplishing anything. Oh, and the other thing is we're going to take the nut off and get those shims out of there, or at least half of it. See what's going on. Yeah, so there's actually two shims. One is actually a little thicker than the other. We're going to leave the one in that was on the treble side of the fingerboard, and that one's going to go away. And with any luck, that'll solve that unbelievably high action at the first fret. Or, you know, we get to take it all apart 80 frickin' times. Right? Wouldn't be fun if you didn't have to take it apart 50 times. Yeah! Well, let's not lose that. So, we'll just, you know, they're all blue. I'm just going to show you. There's no crown there, folks. Nada. There are no crowns on these guys. What are you thinking? I'm thinking that'll work a lot better. Let's look at that ugly finish repair. Okay. These are lacquer sticks. Oh no, and I broke the black one like a dummy. That's okay. And this is the knife down here. And that's the alcohol burner. So what I'm going to do, I need this stuff over here, is take some good old Vaseline and we're going to paint that all around the edge where we don't want this to stick. And then I'm going to, it's been a while since I've done this, but what I'm going to do is heat up my knife
And I'm gonna melt some lacquer into that defect and push it in and smooth it in and hopefully not make a big mess. I think I wanna get that propped up a little bit. What do we got for that? See? These work great for stuff like this, right? Right? Boom. Done. I love it. Well, maybe not. Maybe that's what I want. But I can't have it wobbling about. Let's try this. Yeah, that's the ticket right there. You know, I'm sure you guys are enjoying this. And actually, I don't know if I've even ever done a video of me doing a finished repair like this. Like I said, paint that whole edge where I don't want the lacquer to stick. I might offer a little tape protection there too. Just in case I get all crazy with the knife. See, get a little campfire going. Potential to screw this up is quite high. Come on, not quite hot enough. And then, yeah, have a rag to clean it off. A little bit warmer. Oh, look at, I made a stringy thing. Campfire going here. Am I warm enough? Come on, you can do it. That's why it's important to put Vaseline where you don't want this shit to go. It doesn't help when it... I like the way it broke off like that last time. I'm fine yet, folks. Well, I got some on me. Oh, my lacquer stick exploded. Son of a bitch. That really sucks when that happens. But this little piece might be a better piece to use. I know it looks a mess, or maybe it doesn't, but that's the Vaseline, right? Yeah, I don't know. I don't think these sticks go bad. I think I got dropped when I moved, and they're really brittle. Right? Yeah, now I'm getting the hang of it. Like I said, make sure you got a rag, clean the extra shit off. Well, come on, don't be that guy. Okay, so what I should be able to do is clean that all up in a minute, get rid of the Vaseline, and I should have a pretty decent repair that at least I can build on. That, what I think it is, could be. We'll fix that. So I'm just getting ready here to do another pass so I can get the camera to cooperate. And so what happens is wherever the Vaseline was, that lacquer stick just flaked away. I'm going to offer a little tape protection so I get a little better cut line at the edge. Oh, look, somebody likes me. I wonder how much.
Yes, it's kind of lumpy and ugly, but we will sand that back once it gets good and hard. It is already, but I'm just going to let it sit. And then I can probably drip fill any of the real things that stick out after that and polish it up. But anyway, those are the sticks, right? You see they come in colors, even clear. And you can tell I really haven't used much other than the clear or the black. I haven't had a shit color guitar or a dog poop brown one. Or a puke yellow one, but I'm sure they'll happen one day.
Okay. So now we're gonna fool around with a little bit of wet sanding where I did that repair, which was yesterday. Chances of screwing this up are great. That's why I've got the mask around where I didn't do a repair. Because I just want to level that spot. It'll take a little bit of time, but I'll get it. And we'll polish it. It'll be as good as it can be. Sure.
Okay, so I had to do a couple little minor brushy touch-ups and I gotta polish it, right? But definitely gonna be a lot better than it was.
Okay, so while I'm fidgeting with that, we'll have a little viewer mail interlude. I love viewer mails. Okay, and as my mama taught me when I was a youngster, before you rip into the gift, open the card. Right? Right? Right, kids? Lesson to be taught to the children. Before you rip into the gift, open up the card. Because you never know. Okay, interesting looking card. If I can get it out of its satchel. Come on, you can do it, Dave. Here we go. Okay, this wasn't quite what he meant when he asked for an iPad for Christmas. I like it. I'm not going to reveal anybody's secret identity. Dave and family isn't much, but at least it's the gauge that you use for labellas, probably for drop D. Have a good one, Rob and family. Thank you, Rob. Anybody that takes time to do this, it's like you're a bigger fan of me than I am of myself. All right. So we have the Labella HRS 10-48 and this to Ernie Balsack's hybrid slinky. Those are the ones I like. I gotta be honest though, you know what happens to this? I usually end up donating it to people that have none. Anyway, we'll continue on with this TV turkey and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, let's get out the wheel of death and see if we can actually make this guy shine again. Conversation's gonna be really tough. I'm getting dangerously close to the edge here, and I'm going to have to retouch a little bit of this by hand once again. Just because, but it's way better than that big gash that was there before. There's another little one on the front that I'll touch up after the guitar's back together. What do you figure? Time to make this thing gold. That's okay, that's better than it was. You wind back and see that big ugly mess there was. Now it's at least smooth and you don't look at it no more.
Okay, so I got the claw all jammed in there because I don't want that thing to work at all. And now I'm going to put strings on it. Fun times. You guys know how much we love working on these. If you want to maintain your sanity, just take this thing right off when you're putting new strings on. Trying to thread through and around and You know, nice idea there, guys. But, you know, sometimes, I mean, this whole headstock's a little weird with the four and the two, and then the two are like sideways, right? Something like that. Anyway, it's got strings on it. Let's see how bad everything is. Okay, we got strings on it. It's tuned to bitch, tuned to bitch. Let's see what the neck straightness is like now. Because we need to do that. And right now, it needs a tiny little tweak. But it was really out of whack. Like, really, really out of whack when I first started on this thing. What am I looking for? How's that one? That looks like a sacrificial lamb. That's probably going to be just enough. I'll bet you. Incremental adjustments of your truss rod over the life of the vehicle. Life of the vehicle, nice Dave. Life of the guitar. Yeah, it still could be a little better. Okay. Time to lock it down. And, like I said, I don't have to crank on these like they're lug nuts on a truck wheel. That should do it. And because this guy doesn't float, shouldn't be too crazy. Let's see what happens. Before I crank these things down, I usually just tune the guitar a tiny bit flat. Intonation for the nation, which wish me luck. These just suck balls. So realistically, unless you have this little gizmo, you're gooned. Okay, that's all I'll say. It just is next to impossible to get this to stay where it should stay while you tighten it, because you have to loosen the string. And, you know, hence I'm going to be unlocking the other end at some point, probably. But let's just check the intonation.
Yeah, so.
Oh, forgot. Fine tuners. Somebody's cat likes the intonation song. Oh, B string looks a little flat. For it now, because not only does this need to move, these two strings are a little bit flat, which means this needs to move that direction. And guess what? It ain't. Gotta move it into that spot. All right, wish me luck. Okay then, we don't need to listen to this. Oh goodness. And here's where I get into trouble. Gizmo keeps everything from splintering apart, and so this needed to move. Fuck, my hand's gonna be in the move here. It needed to go that way a little bit. Lock it down there and see how we did. But you got to take this off because it disturbs the tuning. So it's supposed to work something like this, but why don't it want to turn no more? Why am I stuck? Let's try that, see what's going on. Did it just start coming right back? There. Right there. See what I mean about it disturbs the tuning? There! Let's lock it down again. Gotta sprout that control, and I got this one other little chip that I'm gonna just hit with a little bit of tinted lacquer, just so, you know. Keeps it from getting bigger over time. So, okay, yeah, locking it down and the rest. Okay, there's the before. Okay, and there's the after. Magic. Huh? Okay, folks, I think I pretty much quit that kind. Cleaned up the crackly control. Seems pretty skooky. I did check that all the frets work. Get rid of that chunk in the front and
the big ugly sucker on the back. I just like doing this. Cheers, folks. Thanks for all the support. See you next time.